What's going on? It's Craig Cloud here, another Mastercam tutorial. I hope you're having a good time. If you need any help or any further assistance, go ahead and leave a message in the comments below, and I can, if you're in Minnesota, I can come to your shop and I can help you out, and you just tell me what your issue is, and then I'll be able to help you out on that. There will be a fee for that, of course, outside of my training here on Mastercam and YouTube. So if you are looking for training or anything else as such, go ahead and leave it in the comments below, and I'll get a hold of you, and I'll contact you, and we'll get everything running for you. But anyways, let's get going. We're going to do a Mastercam ramp today, and that stems from the 2D toolpath called Contour. So let's dive right in. Okay, I'm going to open up my 2020 student edition. All right, and the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to grab my circle. And I want to make my diameter 500 thou. So I just went into diameter 500 thou, and then I hit enter. And then I'm going to hit O. After I hit enter, I'm going to hit O for origin. So that's going to be right on your origin. And if you don't want to hit O, just hit Alt F9. Just F9, okay? And go ahead, let's make another circle. And this circle is going to be 610th, let's just say. Okay. And I'm going to move him off. This is just for me showing you how to do the contour. So you don't have to draw these two circles. You can just draw the one circle. That's just fine for you, or whatever circle you already have. So what you're going to want to do here is you want to figure out what tool to pick. Let's go to your smart dimension. Okay, we know what it is, but I just went to my smart dimension and I just clicked on the outside here. So we have a 610. I'm going to click that center. We have a 610 and a 500 thou. So now, what cutter do you pick to do this ramp toolpath? Well, I can tell you what color to pick. What cutter to pick. So let's see. Let's go in here. Go into your wireframe. Okay, you don't have to do this. This is just me showing you how to select. Okay, let's say we have a quarter inch end mill. Okay, if we did that, we're gonna have a little sliver right here in the center that it's not gonna cut. So now what you need to do for the most freest cutting, you need to go a 16th of an inch, and for smaller end mills a 32nd, but usually go a 16th of an inch or the next fraction you have in the shop. You want to go that. So from that, a quarter inch is going to, I'm going to say a 5/16 end mill is what I'm going to want to use. So now let's look at that here, a 5/16 end mill. Okay, I'm going to hit enter. Look at that. Now see, it's definitely going past. Okay, so look at all the free space we have in there though for that end mill. All right, so let's say we wanted, okay, we had a 3/4 inch end mill. So now here's the difference, okay? You just took out half of your chip evacuation with that one fraction. So that's why just that 16th of an inch or whatever it is, it's that fraction is gonna make a huge difference. So if you wanted to make both of these holes here with one end mill, what end mill would you pick? It's gonna be the one fraction above a quarter inch, which is 5/16, a 16th of an inch. That's the rule of thumb. So we're gonna come in here, we're gonna go to our tool paths, contour, and in case you don't have a machine selected, you're gonna go to your machine, go to mill, and default, or whatever one you got, and whatever the default is, or whatever the first one comes up that says mill, click that one. Now go to your tool paths and select contour. Okay, and just select that circle so the arrow is going counterclockwise. See, the arrow is going to be going counterclockwise. A green check. Now, the 5/16 tool I have in there already conveniently. So, I want to ramp this tool. So, I'm going to put in here ramp 500 thou diameter. All right, and then I'm gonna come in here. Okay, I was on tool, and I'm gonna go to cut parameter. Switch that to ramp. All right, and rule of thumb is to ramp at an angle at 1 degree. That'll give you the most even amount of passes. Do not select linearized helixes. That'll give you a bunch of unnecessary code. So now when I'm doing these ramp paths, I like to leave a little bit of stock, all right? Lead in, lead out. Lead in, lead out isn't gonna matter as long as it lead ins and outs. Lead in and outs at the inside the envelope that we got here. So let's say it's 500 thou deep. Go through your other stuff, make sure your coolant is on. Okay, now you're just gonna regenerate that. Hit the green, regenerate. Now, middle wheel on your mouse and slide it up. You'll see that you created a path. Now you can see that 1 degree, it barely gets you. It's not really much of a path. So you can either change that by angle or by depth. It's like, okay, so every 360, how far down do you want a half inch end mill to go? In aluminum. Okay, I'm gonna say 200 thou, okay? So that looks insane. I don't like the way that looks. I want it to be a nice, neat looking path. So my ramp depth is gonna be 100 thou. All right, and I keep hitting the wrong one up here because I'm used to something else. Okay, so there we go. So now that's just gonna come in there. And you can see at the very bottom, you need to select make final pass at bottom. Okay. Go ahead and hit that save icon right there after you do all this stuff. Okay, I keep hitting that top one. Okay, hit the green refresh. There we go. So now there's your path. Okay, so now if we use that same end mill, and that's just roughing. If we use that same end mill to go over to this 610, okay, let's copy after. Dang it. Copy after. Okay, I didn't explain how I did that. Let me explain how I did that. Okay, let me delete this. Delete. So you're gonna click right here. So it green checks. And then you're gonna right click, hold, drop down, and let go. And hit copy after. That's how you're going to copy that. Let's go to your chain. Rechain all. And I'm going to grab that 610 diameter. Okay, now what I want to do is I'm going to add 610 minus 500, which is 110. Okay. I'm gonna hit regenerate. So I forgot to tell it. Let's go back into your lead in, your multi passes here. We're gonna give it two passes at that. Two passes. There you go. Now that's gonna act the exact same as this tool path here. But it's no, that ain't right. I gotta put in diameter. Yeah, see, I had to put in diameter. So 55, that's your, or radius, sorry, that's radius. So your multipass, put two, put that half of, you know, your one diameter is 500, your other diameter is 610, so that gives you 110. So divide that in two, that's where I got 55 from. And that's gonna give you the exact same beginning path. So now that same tool is doing that same exact path. So now technically, if we came back into this path and we added this chain, it's gonna give you an error, but it's gonna still give you the same exact path. Oh, no, it's not, I'm sorry. I was wrong. There's still enough room in there to do that. So don't do that, okay? Don't do that. Okay. It's not displaying my toolpath. There we go. So there you have that. So now these are both roughed out. So you can see it, watch it cook in there. Okay. I have my nice tool assembly. And you can see that the cutter is cutting very freely. Okay. Now the reason why I picked this instead of, what is it, whole frickin' some frickin', what is it? Circle mill. It's because circle mill people just want to use the one path. And you can do that with ramp too. But what I like to do is now I'm going to grab this top one here, because that's what I want. I want the first one. And I'm going to copy after. And I'm going to add chain. So what I did is I copied after like before. I selected geometry. I right-clicked, and I said add. Now I'm just going to select this other one, because we didn't have that selected. And this one's going to be, you know, we're going to finish this, okay? So we're going to go into that toolpath. We're just going to hit 2D. And we're going to take this out. We want this to be zero. All right. And then on our lead in, lead out, we want to make sure it's enter on first depth. These two are in exit on last depth only. Then we're going to go to multi-passes. All right. We're just going to go into spring passes and put two. Now you'll see that the tool stays in the cut. I keep hitting that save button up there. The tool stays in the cut. It'll keep going around. It won't exit. See? So now you're going to get a nice smooth finish all around them guys. And now that is my tutorial today on... Mastercam Ramp. And let me know if there's any small thing you would like me to do a video on that isn't going to give you all the gold treasure that you need to be as good as I without forking over a little bit of inspiration for me, right? Anyways, thank you. And once again, leave your comments in the bottom here. I can help you out on a day-to-day basis if you are needed to, and if you got some money for me, all right? Take it easy.